I've frequently been asked in private messages how I became Google Developer Expert in Angular, what are requirements to become the one, and what the Google Developer Experts program is about. My quick poll on my LinkedIn account showed that this topic is pretty interesting for most of you, so I decided to create this video where I'm going to share what is Google Developer Experts program, what are requirements to become GDE, and in the end of this video, I will share with you what I did in order to become Google Developer Expert in Angular. If it is your first time on my channel, my name is Dmitry Mzhensky and I create content, tutorials and courses about Angular, helping others to become better Angular developers and trying to make complex Angular topics very easy and clear. Later, you can check out my other topics that I covered in the past, but now let's focus on Google Developer Experts program. This video, I would like to start by highlighting what Google Developer Experts program is not about, because there are some misconceptions about it, so I would like to clear it up at the very beginning. First, GDE program is not about knowledge certification or knowledge validation. This is not a certificate that says that you are senior or middle or junior developer. This is completely different concept. By the way, talking about Angular, there is no any official certification program from Google at all. Secondly, being Google Developer Expert doesn't mean that you work for Google. This program and work for Google are completely separate things. As a GDE, I don't have any employment contract with Google or work directly for them. So if it is not a job, it is not a knowledge certification what Google Developer Experts is about. The GDE program is a way how Google supports and recognizes professionals who have deep knowledge of a certain Google technology, and they actively help their community by sharing their experience. For me, that's Angular, but there are GDEs for other technologies like Flutter, Google Cloud, Firebase, and others. Here you can see the whole list of categories where you can become GDE. Of course, there are some great benefits to being Google Developer Expert, and I will name just a few of them. First of all, those are badges. You will get two of them. The first one is a digital one that you can apply to your avatar on your social media profiles. And the second one is an offline. You can see it right here. It looks like this certificate that just proves that you are part of a GDE program. And there you can pin different badges from other events you will be attending. And talking about events, this is the second benefit, because the most active GDEs are being invited to different events and conferences that are organized by Google. For example, a few years ago, I attended Google I/O in Amsterdam, or last year I visited a conference organized by Google for content creators. It was in Singapore and it was a great opportunity to visit this beautiful country. Then, networking. This is one of the biggest perks, in my opinion, because you can connect with other GDEs around the world, GDEs from other categories as well, or you can even talk directly to Google product teams. I mean, to the people who actually develop the product where you are an expert. Of course, you get early access to new features. This is cool because we know a little bit earlier about new features, about upcoming RFCs and things like that. We can not unfortunately spread this information publicly because we all signed the NDA contract that doesn't allow us to share confidential information until it is public. But for me personally, it is useful because it helps me to adjust my content strategy and things like that. And there are some other smaller benefits like free subscription to JetBrains products, for example. So I have the free subscription for WebStorm, though I'm not using it. I use VS Code because I got used to it, but still, it's good to have. Now, when we know the benefits of being Google Developer Expert, let's talk how to become the one. I would say that this process is pretty clear in terms of requirements, but it is quite quite challenging when it comes to implementation. In a few minutes, you will understand what I mean. First of all, you have to be 18 years old and you have to freely speak in English, because all the interviews, all the processes will be in English, and English, this is the language of this community. Then you have to have the technical expertise in the field where you want to be a Google developer expert. I think it's pretty obvious. Then you have to have a good communication skill. So you should be able to explain concepts well enough and provide helpful advice to other people. And the most important requirement is the community involvement. And here I would like to focus more on this requirement. So how your activity can be represented. So I split it into multiple categories, and the first category is a content creation, and it can be any kind of content. This might be videos like I do, this might be blog posts, or I know you can write a book, or you can run your podcast, things like that. The second category is teaching and coaching. This can be some public or private trainings, mentoring, creating online courses, creating webinars, things like that. The third category is open source contributing. So you can contribute to the product itself, or you can create libraries that have a big impact on the product ecosystem. For example, if you are an Angular developer, you can create a library that will be very popular and helpful for other developers. Or if you don't want to create your own library, you can contribute to already existing ones. There are a lot of awesome libraries like, I know, AnalogJS, NGRX, RxAngular, I know, SpartanNG, NG Extension. There are a lot of them. Just pick the one you like and contribute. Another quite important category is public speaking. So you can be a speaker at different conferences and meetups. Or if you have a lot of time, you have a lot of energy, you can try to organize your own meetup. This also counts as a contribution to the community. It's best to stay active in multiple categories, because if you create only blog posts or you create only videos, it might be not enough. So the more areas you are active in, the higher your chances. And of course, consistency matters. And this is exactly what makes this process hard. It is not enough just to be active community member from time to time. You have to do it consistently during the long period of time. How long? No one will tell you exactly, but it is recommended to be active community member for around 2 years. And unfortunately, no one can share with you any exact numbers and tell you that, okay, your blog post or your videos should have this certain amount of views, or you should do this certain amount of public talks during the year. This information is confidential, and I'm pretty sure that these requirements are different for each category. For example, the requirements for GDE in Angular might be slightly different for requirements for being GDE in Google Cloud or Flutter. The only thing I can say certainly is that the more views, the more impact your content has, the higher chances to become a GDE. Later in this video, I will share with you my statistics that I had when I applied to the GDE program, but please don't rely too much on these numbers, because it was like 4 years ago and most probably requirements changed since that time. Anyway, let's imagine that you are already a successful content creator. You contribute to the product where you want to become a GDE. You take part in different conferences as a speaker, and you think that you fulfill all the requirements. What would be your next step? And let's talk about the nomination and the application process. There are four steps, and the first one is a nomination. So you have to be referred by another Google Developer Expert or Google employee. Actually, it is not so hard as it seems, especially if you are an active community member and attend different meetups and conferences. There you can easily meet other GDEs and ask them to refer. If everything is fine and you are nominated, then soon you will get a special link that leads to a form where you have to fill out information about yourself, information about your experience, your motivation, why you want to be a member of Google Developer Experts program, and you would need to define your community activities. This is what I mentioned before. So there you drop the link to your activity, to your blog post or video, etc. And there will be a field where you should define how many views this video or blog post had, or if it's a public talk, then how many people came to this event, etc. Once it is done, you submit the form and you just wait. How long should you wait? No one can tell you. It can be a couple of weeks, it can be a couple of months, but if everything is fine, you will be invited to the next step, and the next step is the community interview. Community interview, this is pretty quick, like 30-40 minutes video chat with another GDE from your region and from your category. And on this interview, you will discuss again your motivation, maybe your future plans, your future activities. And fairly speaking, I cannot imagine how you can fail this interview. After the community interview follows the product interview. And this is something like technical interview, right? Because you will be interviewed with someone from Google who works on the product where you want to be Google Developer Expert, and they will be asking you about particular features of product. But don't be afraid, it is not so hard like a regular interview in Google. So no questions about data structures and algorithms, no whiteboarding. There will be regular questions about the product itself, and in my perception, it was not harder than the regular interview for senior Angular position. The only thing I noticed that it seems like they pay more attention not on your knowledge, but more how you explain things, how you express your thoughts, and how you deliver the information. After this interview, you just wait. How long? No one can tell you, but if everything is fine, you will get an email that looks like this and says that now you are Google Developer Expert. But of course, you can be also rejected, but don't afraid. If you are rejected, you can try one more time after, I think, 6 months. All right, and now, as I promised, I'm going to share with you my statistics that I had at the day when I submitted application form to the GDE program. So let's have a look what numbers I had at this day. As you can see, I've been a Google Developer Expert since August 16, 2021. My first video on this channel I uploaded on March 2, 2020, which means that overall it took for me 1.5 years to become a GDE. At the day when I submitted the form, I had 50 videos uploaded on my channel. Some of them were not exactly about Angular. I think 10 of them, or approximately 10 of them, were about Hasura GraphQL engine. But there, in that videos, I used Angular as a secondary tool. Then I had around 8,000 subscribers at that moment, and I had 180,000 views in total on my channel. It means amount of views for all my videos I uploaded since the very first day until the day when I submitted the application form. During that time, I took part in 4 podcasts and conferences as a speaker. And at that moment, I created 2 courses. One was about Angular material theming, and it had around 200 students on all platforms where this course was hosted. And I had a course about Hasura GraphQL engine. It is not about Angular again, but Angular was used as a secondary tool in that course as well. And that course had around 5,000 students in, again, in on all platforms where it was hosted. Those are my numbers. I hope I forgot nothing, and it was enough for me to become a GDE. But again, please don't take those numbers as exact requirements. It was four years ago. At that time, it was enough. Right now, no one knows. But those numbers might be a good guidance for you and give you some perception of the amount of work you have to do before you can be nominated to the GDE program. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video until the end. I hope this video was useful and motivated at least some of you to become GDE as well in the future. Don't give up, this is doable, just be consistent and do a great job. And again, if you are first time on my channel, don't forget to check out my videos I created in the past. Leave your comments, leave your thoughts, check out my video courses about Angular, and I wish you a productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next video.